Hello everyone, this is Xenozer here. Welcome back to Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 3, Full Burst. There was a big explosion, and then we're gonna find out what was the cause, and where it came from. Hopefully. Even though we know where it came from. Now, we're playing as Yamato, well, this is Chikage's granddaughter, versus Hooded Kabuto is what I usually call him. You'll see why I don't call him by his actual title. Spoilers for characters later on.
User Yamato with him. And what about you?
I don't get it. He disappeared so suddenly.
Deidara was nothing but a diversion. When he finished playing his part, Kabuto probably just released the jutsu. least he didn't go after the Eight Tails and Nine Tails. It's hard to tell whether he was looking for any hostage to interrogate or wanted that Woodstyle user in particular. But either way, we'll have to worry about an intel leak.
Master Yamato is not that easily broken, sir.
That's not the issue. He's up against Madara, he of the powerful visual jutsu. No matter how strong Yamato's will, it's no match.
No way.
I don't believe that's the souvenir I asked for. Weren't you supposed to deliver the Nine Tails?
No, it's not. But this one is the Nine Tails Guardian and also possesses classified information. Plus, I can use him to make the Zetsu army a lot stronger. After capturing him, I elected not to take further risks and chose the most expedient option for you.
Then hurry up and do it. This left eye of mine is itching for battle.
I see. So Yamato.
I never imagined he would take another ninja instead of going for the Nine Tails.
Still, we can't do anything as we are now.
Well, we'll just have to get him back later. We know the rough location. Isn't that right, Lady Tsunade?
What do you mean?
Ah, that's right. You were never told. The other day, we received information that our recon unit had discovered their hideout.
Really?
The X marks the enemy's hideout. It's in the mountain graveyard.
From here, we would have to pass through the Hidden Steam Village and Hidden Frost Village, but...
Yes. Because of that, we have already advised both nations to evacuate.
I see. And what about our own preparations?
We've already summoned the commando unit and assembled the main battle regiment.
The same goes for the medical, intel, and sensory units. The Ninja Alliance can move immediately.
So that means we are ready.
Tsuchikage, I believe these are yours.
Ah, they're finished already? Oh, so these will be our Allied Force headbands, huh? Nice job.
Thank you. I designed them. You may have squabbled in the past, but right now you are one. Simply ninja. And this time, samurai shall team up with ninja. Now, let's get to work. In the fourth great ninja war, we will be victorious.
Yes.
Terror shakes the world. Anxiety scorches the air. The sky will shudder. Silence will fall. And humanity will feel that war is coming. To meet the approaching threat, a ninja will rise up. The era will fill with bravery and evil. With hope and death. It is time to battle. It is time to begin war.
Chapter 5, Plotting Behind the Scenes, is complete. Now we move into the fourth Great Ninja War Arc. I believe the next cutscene should be starting first before anything. And I want to get that first cutscene done before we end off. Yeah, this is a great cutscene, so I'm going sharp.
Themselves throughout history. Now then, what will you make of this situation? Main battle regiment, commander in chief?
Out of nationalism, ninja have hated each other for many years. From the first to the third great ninja wars. That hatred bred a lust for power, which gave birth to me. I, too, used to be a Jinchuriki, the embodiment of those two vices. I hated this world and all people. I yearned to destroy both. In some ways, I was no different from the Akatsuki. But one leaf ninja stopped me. That ninja cried for me, his enemy. He called me friend even though we had fiercely battled each other. He saved me. We were on different sides, but we were both Jinchuriki. There can be no bad blood between those who've experienced the same pain. There are no enemies here in front of me. For we all bear the pain of having been hurt by the Akatsuki. There is no sand, no stone, no leaf, no mist or cloud. We are all simply ninja. If you still can't forgive the sand, you can come back and face me when the war is over. That friend who saved me is now a target of our enemy. He falls into their hands. The world as we know it is finished. I want to protect that friend and this world. I am too young, too inexperienced. So please, lend me your strength.
Such a great speech.
First we have former Akatsuki members, then former Jinchuriki. In addition, previous 5 Kage title holders. And finally, a collection of other exceptional ninja. Well, quite a lineup, wouldn't you say? Besides, I was able to use Yamato's wood-style chakra to make Zetsu stronger. Of course, that includes the 100,000 Zetsu underground.
So you've gathered quite the military potential.
What about you? I seem to recall that you made Danzo's body your own in order to get hold of the Eye of Shisui.
I couldn't retrieve it. Danzo crushed his own light before he passed on.
That's a shame. If we had his eye, the war would be even more in our favor. Our military potential is powerful enough without it. It's impossible for us to lose.
Don't let down your guard. They're amassing quite the military potential as well.
Oh, I know. But that doesn't change the fact that we have the advantage. Does it?
It won't be long. Let's go. The war begins. Chapter 6, The Outbreak of War.
Disturbances in the area. But this is when they're most likely to.
Of our unit.
Damn!
I was just trying to say hello. Guess it was a little too much for you guys.
I see you're just as flashy as ever, Data.
You. You're Sasori of the Red Sand.
It's been a long time, Kakuro.
Nobody Sasori crushed that time.
You're deep into enemy territory. You're also a commando unit, aren't you? It's unusual for commando units to engage each other like this.
If we win here, we can decide the flow of the war. That means this war is ours. Too much for a small fry like you to take on.
Someone who left the battlefield has no right to stand up again. The old days ended a long time ago. Your jutsu won't work in this new age.
Hey, that's big talk for a nobody like you.
Come, Kuro. You can boast. But can you take me on and prove it? Prove that your secret black technique is beyond my secret red technique. That a new age is dying.
That jerk! He's manipulating our comrades' bodies!
First, I'm going to apologize. My cat is deciding to take over. Think, well, yeah. We get to fight Sasori with Sasori's body. We don't get to use that version of Sasori ever, even as a support. I wish we did, slightly. I won't lie.
Stop that.
quite an easy battle for a first battle, but after this, the fights get much harder, much, much harder. This is where one of the first spikes in difficulties comes up. Again, I am so sorry for my cat. She really, really wants to be pet today, apparently.
In the clash of the commando units. We too sense that enemy numbers had dropped. We have won the first battle.
Yes.
How's the combat situation?
There was a report that the commando unit of the Alliance forces just annihilated the enemy's commando unit.
So that's the first victory.
How are things at the other battlefields?
It's already been a few hours since the companies took their positions. The fighting should be starting now. Take a look.
And this is how we choose our battlefield. Except for... Second Company, I believe it is. Yes, Second Company, we never get to play. This is the thing that saddens me. I kind of wish we did. But we can choose which foe we fight, really. Only when the opponents get close. So, I believe it's 5th Company, 3rd Company, and then 1st Company. All these are basically boss fights. So, next time on Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 3. We will be truly starting this great ninja war. This is Zeno and Azuma, signing out.